So our guest for today, Dr. Vishakha, is a doctor practicing as a pediatrician and family physician for more than 25 years now. She has done a graduation and a post-graduation from Government Medical College, Nagpur. At present, she's doing her MA in counseling psychology. And prior to all this, she worked with Larsen & Toubro as a medical officer at the very beginning of her career, catering to their large family of employees. Her family is nuclear with only one daughter, she says, but she's at the same time friend, philosopher, and guide to a really, really large extended family of parents, siblings, cousins, in-laws. And ask me, I've known her since school, and I know that she's always available for family and friends. She enjoys reading, watching television, and gardening, and her garden is my envy. Being a pediatrician, the close proximity to children helps her understand their problems, which was one of the reasons she immediately agreed to do this interview with me. Welcome, Vishakha.
Thank you.
So can I start the session by asking you what has been the biggest achievement in your life till date?
Biggest achievement would be obviously my career. I am satisfied with whatever I'm doing in my career, and bringing up my daughter, and her achievements are also my achievements, I think.
Yes. And I know that you brought up your daughter very well. So if I were to ask you that in your life till now, as you see yourself, just choose three words to describe yourself. What would those words be?
I am a patient person.
Yes.
And I think I am mentally strong too.
Very strong.
And a bit introvert.
Very much an introvert. I agree with all the three things that you said. But have you always been this way? If you look back on your school days or your college years, have you been this way then also?
I was more introvert then. At least now I have opened up a bit. At least I can talk to strangers. After coming in practice, I have opened up.
Mm-hmm.
Because I have to talk a lot with patients, counsel them, especially when dealing with children. I have to deal with the parents, with the grandparents. Mm-hmm. So I have opened up, I think.
So you have improved over the years.
Yes.
So who do you think has influenced you most in this change that you see in yourself?
I couldn't hear you, Ramya. Can you repeat the question?
I can repeat the question. Who do you think has influenced you most in this change that has come about in you?
My family, my sisters, and my friends like you. And my daughter, these people have helped me a lot in opening, especially you have helped me a lot.
Thank you.
You have been pushing me everywhere.
I'm happy that you think that is an improvement in you.
Yes, definitely.
So you mentioned your parents when you spoke about the influence in your life.
Yeah.
How much and how have they influenced you? Can you tell us something about that?
My father is a very strong person. He had he was an orphan when he grew up.
Mm-hmm.
And from that, from zero, he has built up everything. So he's a big inspiration for us. And he was very particular that his children should study very hard and achieve a lot in life, and it was his dream that I should become a doctor. But he never talked about his past, that he had, what type of life he had. We came to know about him from others, but he never told us much about it. So he's a very strong person. So he has helped me his life is a big inspiration. And my mother too, she hasn't studied so much. She studied till 10th standard only.
Mm-hmm.
But with that, she knows how to deal with people, how to talk with people. And mm-hmm. she's a very bold person.
Yes.
So that has also helped me. My sisters also.
Mm-hmm.
Especially my second sister, Anju.
Mm-hmm.
She's a very strong person. And mm-hmm. She lives life to the fullest. And that is what we have learned from her. And we are still learning from her.
So your other sister is also a very strong person, I think.
Yeah.
So also your brother.
Yes. All of us, all four of us, support each other in every crisis.
Yes.
So that's a very strong family bonding which we have.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe because of our parents.
So, as you said, you have your four siblings and you have a very strong bonding. And I know that you had quite a few cousins, some of them who lived with you also.
Yes.
So, how do you feel your childhood was? Do you think it was a safe childhood?
Not really, because mm-hmm. my parents, both of them were working
mm-hmm.
and I was the eldest one. So mm-hmm. I had to take care of my siblings.
Mm-hmm.
But some things did happen
mm-hmm.
that time when I was maybe 10, 11 years. I wasn't mm-hmm. understanding what mm-hmm. Those people were doing.
Mm-hmm.
But I never had the courage to tell to my mother also.
Mm-hmm.
So, actually, we had neighbors, like people were living on rent in a house
mm.
at my mother's place. So, there were mm-hmm. some boys there, boys like pretty old to us. So, mm. they used to, when my parents were not there, they would come inside the house
mm-hmm.
and try to do some, like, hold our breasts and all. And but we were so scared that till date, I haven't told it to my mother.
Mm-hmm.
So, and so, now when I'm hearing about all these things,
mm-hmm.
then I realized that I was also abused. But that time when I was a child, all these mm-hmm. things were not so openly spoken about in society.
Yes. So, so many times we hear this, that it is only when people have spoken to us about it, generated some sort of awareness, that we realize that what happened to us in our childhood was not correct.
Yes.
So, which is exactly that's what true. You're telling us.
For a child, a safe space means emotionally, physically, and like he should be able to communicate whatever mm-hmm. he's facing,
mm.
he should be able to communicate around him.
Mm.
And he should not be scared to talk about the wrong things being done to him. If he's, if he's sexually abused, then he should be able to speak up and he should know how to resist it.
Mm.
See, gender equality,
mm-hmm.
then from child and adult equality, financial mm-hmm. equality, caste mm-hmm. equality.
Mm-hmm.
We have n number of inequalities in our country. It's very rampant, I think. Like, you talk to any female, or even a boy, mm-hmm. even a male, any once in a lifetime, everyone, I think, has faced an abuse.
Hmm.
Because
you're right.
My daughter's friends, when she spoke to them, they have also told her. Each and mm-hmm. everyone had at least one incident
mm-hmm.
where they had faced this type of abuse
mm-hmm.
as child. It's more in family and a trusted circle. Strangers are not so much in number, but within the family or family friends, where the child trusts that person so much that whatever that person is doing, that child doesn't feel that he's doing something wrong to him. Gradually, so, the child feels that this is normal. No, these are not the only solutions. We have to change the mentality of the people. A boy or anybody right from childhood, they should be told that harming other person is wrong for whatever reason. It should not be done. And sex education in schools, I think they would be more helpful.
So that is the...
Now with the mobile in their hand, they are exposed to porn films and all. So these things are also to some extent responsible for these type of things. Like maybe after watching those things, they feel that they should experiment with it. Anything like touching the breasts of a girl, vagina, or penis of a boy, or inserting their penis inside, anal sex, oral sex, and then touching their buttocks. That was a controversial thing recently we heard in a case.
Yes.
So all these things are definitely sexual abuse for a child.
So what about like you mentioned one situation where one man was standing with his penis exposed. Would you consider that exposing his penis to a child? Would you consider that sexual abuse of the child?
Yes. It is sexual abuse.
And showing some nude pictures or cracking sexual jokes with the child.
Yes, that is also sexual abuse. Or online, they tell children to strip off and watch the videos of the child in that position. And then they try to blackmail them. This is also sexual abuse, I think. We should. But there is a taboo around speaking these words in our society. So that apprehension should come out.
That is very much what we are saying. But it is going to take time to remove that shame and taboo associated with that. But let us take a hypothetical case. That if some child is being abused, and you know how children are, they don't come out very easily with what is happening to them.
Yes.
So what would be the signs which will tell you that there is something wrong going on with this child, that some child is being sexually abused?
See, the child first, I think, there will be withdrawal symptoms in that child. He won't be talking properly with you, with the parents or anybody. And the moment he'll see that person, there he will be scared. He will be scared, and those signs will be seen on his face. So the parents have to be very vigilant and aware about the behavior of the child. When the child says that he or she doesn't want to talk to that person, or doesn't want to go with that person, or doesn't want that person to come to the house, that time you should realize that there is something wrong. However close that person is to the family, you should realize that there is something wrong. That is why that child is saying such things. if it's a long standing thing, if it's happened just once and all, still they can't recover. But if it's a long standing one, then it's very difficult. In fact, I have heard about this, that if a boy is repeatedly abused by a male, he becomes something like a transgender then. He loses his sexuality, like his attraction towards female and all. That also he loses. So it's a long-standing trauma, lifelong trauma, I think, that one can't forget what has happened. That's a difficult thing, depends on their family atmosphere.
Yes.
But still, nowadays, parents do act. They this to some extent, there is some amount of awareness. So they do take action and they do take, they do confront them. Because finally, it's their child who is being affected and is suffering. So at least the mother may take some action. I think so. He will make, if he knows that something like this is there, if he's aware about these things, then he should go for it. At least I think the mother will at least think of going there.
So as long as the family doesn't know that they are the ones who have reported it, they would be happy to report. So the POXO e-box is a good thing to have.
Yes, definitely. I am Rakshin.
Thank you. So we come to the end of the session now, where I will just thank you very much, Vishakha, for joining us today. And I will also like to thank you to our viewers formally. Thank you very much for joining us. Yes.
Thank you for inviting me. It was a pleasure talking. And some things which I had never told anybody have come out.
Yes, I realize that. And I was very impressed by what you said about your father.
Yeah.
So I may have heard it before also from you, but then this again brings back that memory that what a person he is.
Yes.
So to thank you once again formally, let me tell you that this is a campaign. This Rakshin project is a campaign conducted by Sakshi in partnership with the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports, specifically to build a world free of child sexual abuse, especially within the families. And here we are trying to create awareness and skill build 18 to 22 years youth so that they can recognize, identify, address, de-escalate, report and resolve sexual abuse within the family and within their communities. And this is necessary because we need to make visible the fact that 90% of the abuse of a child takes place within the trusted circles. And still, it is severely underreported. So what can the law do if the crime is not reported? So with your voice and your support, we are trying to amplify the work that we are doing so that we can give visibility to the fact that why is child sexual abuse not reported, what to do when it is not reported, and what is our role as within the family, as family and as bystanders. So thank you once again
thank you.
For joining us here.